Hi, I'm Jason, a machinist here with Tormach. One of the common questions we get is how to utilize gang tooling with your turret. So we're just going to go over a few different options, a couple different strategies you could possibly do to utilize gang tooling and a turret at the same time. One of the nice features of the Tormach lathe is the ability to even be able to run a secondary tooling option. So we have the turret installed here. You can see our A-position turret. And then we also have a half gang plate installed here. With a two-position block on it. When you're doing this kind of setup, it depends on what you need to do. You can see if we put this boring bar in and we have to bore a hole that's 5 or 6 inches deep, that gives us a lot of tool clearance issues for any of our other tools. So it really limits us on any of our turning tools. We may have to leave a couple of our turret stations empty just to ensure that we don't come into collision with this bar and other ops. So one of the options we can do is we can take this bar and we can put it down here in a gang block and we can mount it. We can still get our 5 or 6 inches of stick out we need, but then that gives us all this space for clearance on our part. So it just gives us that ability to handle a real long tool without having to lose the capabilities of the turret itself. Another option you can do, which is a real common one you see a lot, is guys will set up 3 different pockets and they'll use this for a drill tap or a spot drill and tap operation. So they'll have a spot drill, a drill and a tap all set up down here at the same time. So it just keeps the turret open for other tooling options that you may need. Or if you have real large diameter drills, if you need to drill a large pilot hole to get that big boring bar in there, that is another great use for the gang tooling. So if you have to use a real large diameter drill for a pilot, you can also put this right in one of the gang blocks, install this, and that just also gives you good clearance, because now you can see we're just about the same length as our turret, which gives us nice clearance when we're using our OD turning and our other tools that are loaded into the turret. So you can see once you install gang tooling in here, you do come into more clearance conditions. So we have a limited space here now. So we could fit a 5 or 6 inch diameter part in between our tool one, which our OD turning tool, and our drill. So it's just something to keep in mind while you're doing your setup. It is more complicated once you start adding multiple tool holding options to the setup. So we'll have to pay attention to where this drill is going to be while you're turning with this tool. Otherwise you may need to load an empty station. We may have to leave one turret station empty just to gain the clearance needed to use the gang tooling. But it's just something to keep in mind. There's no right or wrong answer to this. You just find a system that works for the parts that you need to make. And so this is just a couple examples of different ways you can utilize gang tooling with the turret at the same time. Feel free to mix and match and come up with a system that works for you. It is one of the cool features about the Tormach lathe is that you can put multiple tool holding options together. So check out our other videos on other CNC equipment. Thanks for watching.